Good afternoon, everyone, and we'd like to extend a big welcome to all our guests that are here today. We appreciate your attendance here this afternoon, and we would go ahead and call this meeting to order. And please ask that you silence cell phones. And if you'd also please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance, which will be led by Commissioner Kester.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. Let the record reflect that all commissioners are present here for this afternoon's meeting. With that, we will move to our special presentations. We have a couple of citizen awards that we would like to give out this afternoon. And do we have our first recipient? Did he make it? Warren Staves. All right, we will move. We'll circle back. Oh, do we have them? No? Okay. We will move to our second citizen award, Lionel Mudez.
If I may, sir.
Yes, sir.
Let me give a quick little background.
Oh, absolutely.
On what occurred, and then I'm going to call up the crews, any crew that's here, and I think I can see one of them that was here, and then I'll have Lionel Messi come up. I heard Lionel Messi's here. All right, here we go. On July 5th, 2023, SVFD crews dispatched a 911 call with a woman reported to be unconscious and having a possible seizure. Hola. ¿Qué está haciendo? Hola, eh? All right. Once the crew went inside, the boy directed crews to his mother's location and explained that he thought his mother had a seizure. He also called and stayed on the phone and answered all the questions that 911 has. And with normal practice, they ask a lot of questions. And so to answer all those questions is a big deal. In addition to that, he has his 10-month-old sister that was there also that was crying. And during all this occurring, he stepped over there and he picked up his sister, took care of her too. So it's just incredible to call because potentially people can die from seizures. So to be able to call for his mother and then take care of his sister and do all those things is pretty awesome. So I'd like to call up the crew that was there. I believe it was Captain Josh Lofton, Engineer Nick Bertakis, and Firefighter Tim Blattner that were there. Do we have any other members that were on that call?
Not that's here.
Okay, come on up.
I was the first crew on scene. This young man, when I got up to the door and knocked, door is locked. He opened up the window curtains, looked out. I had made sure that it was actually the fire department that was there, ran around, unlocked the door, directed us in where his mom was at, and then immediately picked up the phone, talked to the 911 operator, let her know that we were there, and then his little sister was starting to cry on the couch, and he ran over and picked her up, got her a toy, and then answered all of our questions, just top notch, like a true hero. So, good job, proud of you.
Maybe we get him to teach most adults how to do that.
Huh? Yeah.
Yeah. I love to help my mom. Because I help my mom a lot.
Awesome. Right. Good job.
What a great thing. All right, we'll move on to the next chief.
Okay, at this time we'll be honoring Warren Staves. I hope I'm saying that correctly. Come on up, sir. And I believe Assistant Fire Marshals Crow and Thurman were there. If you guys could come on up. On October 3rd, 2023, at approximately 5:45 in the morning, Valley Fire responded to a structure fire located at 10101 East Main Avenue, Part 14. Mr. Staves there entered, there was a report of heavy smoke and fire, which was confirmed by on-scene units. Mr. Staves entered the fire department with no regard to his own safety and made his way to the back bedroom where a resident of the apartment was located. Mr. Staves grabbed her and was able to lead her out of the burning apartment. And my understanding is you were also burned as well. So, and you're all good, all better. So, awesome. I mean, you literally were not on heaven's door. So, that's just awesome. So, we want to take this time to honor you. That was a quick one.
You gave him the option? Again, thank you.
You want to say something?
No, did you want to? Come on up to the mic. So we have folks online. This is being broadcast out.
A word's nice. I wish that, you know, it wouldn't have happened and people didn't lose their property. And somebody almost died and it was pretty weird.
Well, thank you. You did.
You thank you very much.
Next, we have Chaplain Aaron McNeil, service recognition. Chief Atley.
Good afternoon, Commissioners. Again, very honored to recognize Chaplain McNally for all the work he's done with our organization. He's been burning the middle of both ends on quite a few things. We wanted to recognize him. We were going to recognize him last month, but he was in Lewiston, Maine, dealing with the crisis, which come to find out that was his hometown. So, and again, it kind of is showing of character being there for his community as well. He's been with our department for a couple years now, and he's definitely made a difference. And we will miss him as far as the work he has done. He's always just a phone call away. And again, today we just want to recognize him for his service. Aaron, if you could come up, please.
I would just say thank you for the recognition. Not necessary, but do appreciate it. And have been honored to be able to serve Spokane Valley Fire Department and the citizens. And I just look forward to ones coming on to fill that role. So thank you.
Thank you. Yeah, thank you.
All right, next we have one of our own, Commissioner Bill Anderson, who is retiring at the end of this year. And so we would like to acknowledge him and his service by a service recognition, but I have a few things to say before we do that.
It's a roast.
It's not a roast. It's a burger. It's not a roast.
It's a burger.
So first, I do want to take a moment to recognize Commissioner Bill Anderson. This will be his last regular meeting before he formally retires at the end of the year. Commissioner Anderson has served the Spokane Fire Department for a total of 54 years. That's amazing. In fact, this is the engine that was what he started on. Minus the horses. No. So 30 years as a firefighter and 24 as a commissioner. And just want to acknowledge and thank Commissioner Anderson for his service, not only to the Spokane Valley Fire Department, but to the citizens of our fire district for 54, again, 54 years. That is a very long time to be fighting that kind of service. We just want to say thank you to him for his years of service and dedication to our citizens and to the department. So on behalf of the Board of Fire Commissioners in the Spokane Valley Fire Department, if we could all come forward, we would like to recognize you with a little memento. So basically what it is, it's his commissioner's badge, and it has his name on it and the years of service.
Thank you. Thank you. I'm supposed to say something? Well, yeah, thank you. Thank you all of you for being. My family's here, and all the some of the guys I worked with, but they're getting older too, losing their hair. I've told everybody it's true. I won't miss the job, but it's the people that are here. And I just want to say thanks to all those people who are working for the fire department. We've got the best fire department in the state of Washington. I hope we stay that way. And I hope that I had nothing to do with making it that way. Thank you all so much.
Thank you. Julie, are we good? All right.
Dangerous.
All right, a big thank you to our award recipients, Commissioner Anderson, Chaplain McNally. We want to thank you. We know all the countless hours of service he's given and appreciate his work that he did here for Spokane Valley Fire Department. All right, moving on to the rest of our agenda, our department reports. We'll move on to November 2023 response totals. Deputy Chief Zach Bond, you are on.
Good afternoon, commissioners. A tough act to follow all that great stuff. So, commissioners report for your response totals for November 2023. Again, you've heard me say this time and time again since I got here, this is our busiest November on record. Last year, November 2022 was 1,892. This year, 1,909 responses in November. And that brings us up to just over 21,000 calls for service in 2023. So broken down by call type, as is normal, 83% approximately for EMS, followed by 158 or 8.2% for fire suppression, and about 5.3 or 102 responses for, we call it tech rescue, but that also includes our vehicle accidents. Next slide, please. So unit responses, so several call types necessitate the response of more than one unit. So this is where we're sitting as of the end of November 2023, showed 2,450 responses for a total of 27,615 unit responses. And I'll point out down there at the bottom, Valley Engine 1, Valley Engine 7 are both over 3,000 calls for the year, and we're not done yet. Valley Engine 1 has already surpassed its 2022 numbers by over 100 calls. So things are definitely trending up. I'll also point out that Engine 6 was number three as of end of November, and then followed by Engine 8, but Engine 8 went in service about halfway through March. So you would expect to see Engine 8 right up there with Engine 1 and Engine 7 if they had done the entire year. Next slide, please. So breaking it down by station area, those numbers are a little hard to see. I've got to do some corrections with the contrast there. But so far this year, Station 7 is our busiest first run area, followed by Station 8 and Station 1, which is predicted based on the unit run volumes. Next slide, please. So again, on the top, that's year over year for 5 years for each month. And you'll see that in November, we just barely crested the total for last November. And then moving down to the last graph there, that's our year-to-date totals, and we're almost to our 2022 numbers based on the 2023 bar graph there. We'll highlight a couple of significant incidents, I believe, as the next slide. So we had a couple of large vehicle fires, which can prevent some unique challenges, both with the amount of water that we carry in our fire engines and some of the unique access problems. So this was a large dump truck. Next slide, please. Different view of that. Next slide, please. Another large vehicle fire. This was a fully involved RV on a roadway out near Station 6. Next slide, please. This was a house fire caused by unattended cooking materials that resulted in the death of 27 cats. So it was a bit challenging for firefighters to navigate this one. Next slide, please. So this was one over on our east side. We have a District 8 unit assisting us, just another house fire. Next slide, please. And I highlighted this. This is an evening in November. Temperatures were probably in the 30s, and putting health and safety first for our firefighters. This is one of our firefighters being hosed down with hydrant water just to get the products of combustion off them. Next slide, please. Another house fire out on the west side. This was caused by an exterior structure that caught on fire that moved through the house quite quickly. Some unique challenges with this one: we had a live power line on the Charlie side or the back of that building that firefighters had to navigate. And I think that might do it. All right, and on behalf of operations, I wanted to give a heartfelt thank you to Commissioner Anderson for your service, both the department as a firefighter, as a commissioner. It's been a pleasure working with you. Really have appreciated your insight and your support of the operation and the men and women that are doing the work out in the field. So thank you very much. Best of luck to you and all your future endeavors.
Thanks, Sam. I appreciate it.
Take care.
Thank you, Chief. Next up, we have November, 2023 finance totals report. Finance Director Angela Golden, welcome.
Good afternoon, Commissioners. Today, I'll be presenting the finance report as of end of November 2023. We were 92% through the year. Our revenues were at 96.47% compared to 95.18% last year. We've been kind of trailing on our property tax collections compared to last year, but we pulled ahead this year, and we've already will receive $2.5 million for the November collections in the 1st of December. Our expenses were 80% compared to 80.6%, so relatively the same place as last year. Our wages and benefits were a little bit lower last year, but are lower this year, but our capital outlay is higher. Our debt service includes leases that we have to start reporting, and as of next year, I'll change the title of that so it makes more sense for what we're actually using that for. But overall, the budget is looking really good. For the medical fund, the revenues were at 87.2% compared to 89.3%. The difference is due to prescription rebate amounts. Our expenses were at 80.9% compared to 96.1%, so our claims are still trending downward, which is always good to see. Are there any questions?
No. Any questions for Finance Director Angela Gold?
Yes,
sir. Great. Thank you.
Thank you, Angela.
I'm sure you'll miss my reports, Bill.
Thank you, Angela.
Thank you. All right, now is the time we have public comment, comment in person, submitted public comment from our website listed above. All written comment must be received by 2:30 p.m. to be presented at this meeting. Comments are limited to a maximum time of 3 minutes. Comments must be related to district business and cannot be negatively directed at a district employee. Do we have any public comment? For anybody would like to come up public comment? Don't be shy. All right, seeing none, we'll move to the approval of agenda, the consent agenda, which consists of items which are considered routine and which are approved by a single motion. A board member may remove any item to be considered separately. Do we have any item to be removed tonight? Seeing none, chair would entertain a motion to approve consent agenda.
So moved.
So moved. Commander Sin, seconded by Commissioner Grisco. Any further discussion? Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries. We'll now move to unfinished business of the Board of Fire Commissioners, our policy review, our second reading, which at this point we will go into, let's see, our, this is budget, but that's not, it's our policy, hearing on the policy for this policy review, second reading. Right? I believe so. Let's see. Yeah, so if we'll go ahead and pull those up, first item for review here, policy for information relief, policy number 006, highlighted in red in cross-outs are the changes that were made. Do we have any changes to this? I will not through these from the on the second point, or second read, because we went through these on the first. Anybody have any changes for the year? Do we have a second page on that? Perfect. All right, let's move to policy 007, which is policy for nepotism. Again, the changes are highlighted there in red. Any changes on this policy? Great. We'll move to policy 009, which is the fire chief recruitment and selection. Changes highlighted in red. Any proposed changes there? Hearing none, we'll move on to policy 019, policy for records. Again, the big change here had to do with not listing our fee and that we may charge a fee. Any changes to that policy? Seeing none at this point, Chair would open up for public comment prior to our vote. Do we have any comment related to board policy? All right, hearing none, Chair would then entertain a motion for approval to show as amended.
So moved.
So moved by Commissioner Kester. Second.
Second. Go
ahead, Bill. Second by Commissioner Anderson.
We're going to make him work.
He's already retired.
I'm out of here.
Gentlemen, any further discussion on these board policies that we've amended? Hearing none, all those in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Just as a point of clarification, one of the things that threw me here is I see a budget hearing, and so I thought we had to actually go into a hearing. Do not for policies, it's just a first and second read. Just a point of clarification, that was my mistake on that. So we do not need to reconvene regular meeting. All right, for new business, we have Captain Bob description. Is that you, Chief Soto?
Yes, sir. So we're looking to update our job description for Captain. We did work in coordination with 876. We wanted to make sure that we were able to capture the most amount of personnel within our department to get ready and to train and educate and give them the opportunity to test for captain. And in order to do that, we did need to
update really what has been our captain step process program 1 through 5 since roughly 2008 with very little changes. So again, we coordinated some changes to update and really just bring about more reasonable and up-to-date training and education. And so that's where we're at, and it's ready to go. I think I sent it to you, so you had the ability to see exactly where the changes were. Right. So we did eliminate one of the steps.
Yeah.
Any questions on that one?
For the point of the public, the board had reviewed these prior to our meeting here for the packet. So, Chair would entertain a motion to approve the job description for captain.
So moved.
So moved by Commissioner Anderson. Do we have a second?
Second.
Second by Commissioner Asp. Gentlemen, any discussion regarding this job description or questions? Last chance, Bill. All right. Hearing none, all those in favor? Aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? All right. Next description is for fire inspector.
Yes, sir. So likewise, same thing with fire inspector. We hadn't updated this for a while and wanted to really capture the promotional process and positions, steps, if you will, within the fire inspector position moving up to assistant fire marshal. And so, again, we coordinated with 876 to bring it up to date. And so, again, it's pretty cut and dry, so if you had any questions.
All right. Motion to approve job description for fire inspector.
So moved.
So moved by Commissioner Grisco, seconded by?
Second.
Commissioner Asmus. Any questions or discussion on this job description? Hearing none, all those in favor? Aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries. Thank you. All right, our third item is a cancellation of our second meeting in December. We typically do not hold a second meeting in December, especially this year, this month, since Chris falls on our fourth Monday, which would be our regularly scheduled meeting time. I just don't think people want to be here for a meeting. So Chair would entertain a motion to formally cancel that meeting on December 25th, 2023.
So moved.
So moved by Commissioner Grisco. Second by?
Second.
Commissioner Asmus. Any further discussion? Hearing none, all those in favor? Aye.
Aye.
Any opposed?
No.
We'll note
we'll
one
see you on Christmas.
We'll see you here.
All there. You can be here.
Minority rules. Thank you. All right. With that, we'll move on to the Fire Chief's report.
Not too much, gentlemen. We had a successful holiday open house at Fire Station 6. Apparently, one of you looks really good in a Santa suit. So I'm not going to say who it is, but his birthday was, I think, last month. Any case, I just say Merry Christmas to everyone. Since we won't be back here this month, I also want to say to all of our personnel, thank you for everything that you guys do. I know, especially at this time of year when people are getting together with families, and it's a holiday season, and all I want to do is have a great evening. You know, we have a lot more fire. We have a lot more everything. And there's Mike to prove it. So be careful out there and continue to provide great emergency medical services, the fire prevention services, community risk reduction services, just overall response and operational services. So thank you for everything that you guys do, and press on.
Thank you, Chief. 876 comments. President Ben James.
Good evening, Commissioners. Good evening. A couple of things I wanted to review and say thank you for. In no particular order, you just signed on the captain's step job descriptions, all those things that went together there. Thanks to Chief Soto. Thank you guys for approving those. Since 2008, every single year it's come up for review, refinement, correction, literally since 2008, we just got it done. So that's a huge thing on our plate, something we've wanted done forever. Thank you.
Yeah.
I want to say to Commissioner Anderson, thank you. 54 years. You were 12 years into your career when I was born. There's no way that picture is correct of your first fire engine because it doesn't have a horse.
Yeah, thanks.
Got you. So I just want to thank you for your time, your service. I've got a question for you. I managed to leave my desk when I was head of this chin, so I'll get it to you. But I want to say thank you for the work that's gone into that and thank the commissioners for all the work.
You're welcome. Thank you for your work on that as well. Appreciate that. You and Chief. 3701 representative went out to attend to a structure fire. So is there anybody else from 3701 that would need to speak to this evening? All right. Scene one will. You will?
Yeah.
All right. Chief Boardwell.
All right. Well, Bill, you've done a lot of years here. And if anybody doesn't know, there isn't a cat that Bill doesn't like. They never went hungry around the station. You're an animal lover. You were a good firefighter. You were a great officer. And you were a pretty good commissioner.
Thank you. I think pretty good at what you're doing.
Thank you.
So when he says animal lover, is this to take that he knows the story as well?
Oh, they all do. Everybody knows.
I think everybody knows the story.
Well, Washington Fire Commissioners Association does, thanks to Mike Kessler.
And Jeff has been around since Bill's here, too. So.
Yeah. Well, Jeff's too far behind, so we'll be doing this for him in a little bit. So, anyway, thank you. Thank you for your comment. All right. We'll go to Commissioner reports. We'll start down with Commissioner Brian Asmus.
Great. Thank you very much. I just want to mention that Chief Bonds ended the report that you saw tonight to the Liberty Lake City Council meeting, standing room only. I think everybody was there just to hear his report. Did an amazing job, so thank you for that. And Merry Christmas, Happy Holidays to all of you out there. And again, I want to thank Commissioner Anderson, sitting, I'm the new guy up here. So sitting next to him for the last couple of years, a great deal. I appreciate his mentorship and leadership, and we're going to miss you. Thank you.
Great. Thank you, Commissioner. Commissioner Kester.
I really don't know where to start, Will. First of all, I want to say thank you to Bill for being a mentor for me and teaching me an awful lot over the last 5 years on how to conduct myself at a meeting, what I should do and what I shouldn't do. And I haven't learned yet, but I'm still trying. But anyway, thank you, Bill. I appreciate it very much. And I want to say thank you again to Julie for the putting on the Christmas deal did here on the 2nd. It turned out pretty good. I think a lot of kids and a lot of people had a time. So that was good for our community. And most of all, everybody be safe out there this holidays. The roads are going to get bad. They generally do this time of the year. Everybody be safe and be careful.
Thank you. Commissioner Grisco.
First and foremost, I just wanted to just kind of capitalize a little bit on Bond's report on our amount of responses that we go to. I do this report once a month to the Greater Spokane Valley Chamber of Commerce, and it seems like every month we get gasps. And I just want our department and people to know how much our business leadership and community loves you guys. And it just has the utmost respect, the comments that I get back on what you guys and do for this community. You can just really feel it within our business community. So thank you for that. I just got an opportunity. I just flew back from New York City, and boy, is my wallet tired. I was meeting with my daughter, so feeling a little lighter as I jumped off the plane at 2:00 this afternoon. But what I loved about it is I saw a lot of fire trucks. I don't know if they have a competition, but they have wreaths and Christmas lights, and I think they try to outdo each other. I think it's just fun to see the fire departments too as well, and what they do for their community. Lastly, I want to also thank Commissioner Anderson for his years of service. I'd like to say that if you're, as a new commissioner about 6 years ago, when you're stepping into this position, you have training wheels on. And Bill is the first one to open arms, greet you, want to know if you need anything, any help at any time to give you a call. I also want just the general public to know we don't always agree on everything. And what I like about that is how people will push back on different issues. It's just not to get along, to go along. And Bill's one of those people that push. And we have a lot of good conversations. So I really appreciate it, Bill, about that with you as well. You're a huge asset to this community. Don't be a stranger. We love you, and thank you for your service.
Thanks, John.
Thank you. I don't have those same words. It's hard to believe that I started here in 2016, and there were a few gentlemen on this podium that had many, 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 many more years than me. Bill was one of those people, and to now see him go, it's a sad moment to see that those number of years of experience, not only with the, as a commissioner, but in the fire department, he brought to where he could look at it as not just from a firefighter perspective, but what was good for the community, what was good for the department. And by that expertise and thought and process. And Bill, one thing I'll say about Bill, always concerned about the people, was concerned about the little guy in every occasion. And you've been a great example, and you will be. We love the what you brought to the department, to the commission, and you will be missed. Don't be a stranger.
Okay, thanks.
You bet.
Can I say something?
I'm going to give you last. Okay. I'm not done yet. for Trish, we do have an after-action report at District 3 on Wednesday from 0800 to 1200 hours. I believe we will probably have at least three commissioners present there, so we'll want to go ahead and note that there will be a quorum. Also, I would like to thank all those involved in Station 6 Open House. We seem to exceed, it seems like every event we do, more and more people showing up to our events. And Christmas is one of those special times when you just get to see little kids lit up anyway. When they come to a fire station and there's this big red fire truck. But they light up even more when they see the truck. And then they see the red Santa sitting next to the truck. Does it get any better than that, right? Does it get any better than Santa sitting next to a fire truck? And so what a great opportunity to have these events, open it up to the public, because we're here for you. That's our give back to you, and we hope that everybody takes advantage with the opportunity to come and visit the stations. Those are your stations. We were for you. We're there for you. And thank you to the community for supporting that. Thank you to Julie and her crew that puts all together, for the volunteers, the firefighters that work there, and everybody that had a part in that. We want to thank you for that, especially one of our newest civil service commissioner, Joe Mann, and his wife, Joyce, participated well. And you were handing out fire helmets, if I believe. What a great thing to see him and his wife there. They had probably just as big a smile on their face as the kids that were walking through the doorway. They had a great time. And so thank you and your wife volunteering and participating in that.
They kept Santa supplied in candy canes.
Oh, excellent. That's important, by the way. I had the opportunity to attend the 876 Christmas party last Saturday. Had a great time. Appreciate the opportunity to attend that. I learned a few interesting things about a few of our folks that are in the department that we'll just see what happens at the party stays at the party. But it was a great time. It was very, very well done. And thank you to all those in 876 who had a part in putting all that together. It was a great evening, a great opportunity to socialize. At this point in the year, we get, you know, after a long year, we thought last year was long. I think they just get longer. They seem longer, but then seem shorter, right? It seems like we're just flipping the calendar again after a couple of days. But I want to thank my fellow commissioners. What people don't realize, we do more than just show up twice a month to a meeting. I can attest to this with the 24 he was involved in this. There's a lot of work that you do at home, a lot of reading you do at home, things that you're involved with, your assignments with on various committees, engagements and involvement with the community. A lot of work, a lot of man hours goes into doing what we do. And we do it because we enjoy it. We do it because we enjoy serving the public. We do it because we enjoy serving the department. We have a great department. We have great leadership. We have great staff, great firefighters who every day make our job extremely easier than it could be because of the way you behave and carry out your business. So I want to thank first our firefighters, our staff, the support staff, our leadership for the job well done this year. As Chief Bond keeps reporting, we just keep getting busier and we keep getting better. We're not taking a step backwards. We're not a separation. and that takes a lot of effort. Then lastly, I'd like to thank my fellow commissioners for the job that they do and for the effort that they put into doing this job, because it does require a little bit of sacrifice and some time, but it's well worth it, as I'm sure we'll give Commissioner Anderson the last word, but that he can attest to that. And so lastly, I'd like to just say Merry Christmas to everybody and a Happy New Year, a safe and Happy New Year. Please be safe during the holidays, and have a great and prosperous New Year. With that, I'll turn the word over to Commissioner Anderson.
I forgot what I was going to say.
Probably write it down.
Yeah, right. I just want to thank everybody again for being here. My whole family's here, and I just want Lola to know I can make it to your softball games. I miss some of Ella's. I'm out to make yours. So thank you all so much for being here. Appreciate it. And thank you guys for being with me and taking the heat with me. So I love this fire department. I love the job that I did, and I love the people involved in it. So thank you again.
Thank you, Commissioner Anderson. With that, we'll announce again that our meeting on December 25th has been canceled, and our next regular board meeting, which will be January 8th, 2024, at 4 p.m., where we will be swearing in our newly elected fire commissioner at that point. And so with that, we would also say please feel free to stick around. We have more cake and refreshments here up front to participate in. Take pictures. Do what you need to do. This time after is for you. And with that, Chair would entertain a motion adjourned.
So moved.
Second?
Second.
Second. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Nay.
We are adjourned. Thank you.